Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing a weaning video. I have a 6 month old now and I have been weaning him for a couple of weeks. I know that some people wean from about 4 months to 6 months. I decided to start him off at 5.5 months just to sort of prepare him. I did get the go ahead by my like health visitor. She was completely fine with it. He is on the 75th centile, so it was like completely fine. I've got everything that I want to talk about on my phone because it's just easier that way. I've never done that on a video, just written things down and like gathered my thoughts, and I'm a bit of a blabbering mess in every single video, so I thought I would try it a little bit different today and let's see how it goes. I have been reading a bunch of like books, blog posts, just anything you can imagine. I've been watching a ton of videos regarding this subject. I did wean Lily, obviously, my 4 month old. This is how I blabber. My 4 year old, but that was 4 years ago and I've completely forgotten about it. So I dragged out all the old books that I have from when I weaned her and I reread them all, and I'm completely prepared to now share this information with you. So the first thing is, if you start before 4-6 months, it's to check with your health visitor that like you both agree that that's okay. The second is, head support is very important. Just make sure that they can hold their own head up by themselves. They can sit up, they are curious about food. Every time I would eat and he was like sitting somewhere or just doing something, he would really watch me and like wonder what I was eating. I mean, I don't know if he was wondering what I was eating, but he was just very curious about it. Then I want to talk about essentials. Once that's sorted, you've spoken to your health visitor and you've gotten the go ahead, it's time to get essentials that you need for weaning. And with my daughter, again, I went out and I bought one of these like baby blenders, which are not very great. I just use my normal blender with him and it works exactly the same. Like, you don't need to spend money on that. You do need a high chair or like a chair to like sit him in. I don't know if you guys can see that, but there's one just there, and it was Lily's plastic cutlery and bibs. I went out and I bought him a set. It was in Sainsbury's and it was £5, and there was about 5 plates, like little brown baby plates with lids. And how many spoons were there? There was no spoons. No, I lied, there was no spoons. I bought the spoons separately and there was 2 spoons for about £2.50 or something like that. But I've also gotten spoons by Timmy Tippy, I think it's called, from Poundland. So if you get around to Poundland and you just want to grab those, they're really good. I use them as well and there's no difference basically, and there's 2 for £1 and they have them in pink and in blue. With bibs, I ruined a lot of bibs using like fabric bibs until I went out and I bought him one of these really obnoxious plastic bibs with like the fold up bit so that all the food stays there. We don't use that bit yet, but we will eventually when he starts like eating by himself. The first foods that are great to start with are broccoli, which is actually the one, like the first one that I started him on, and he loves it. It's his favorite vegetable that I make. His least favorite right now are sweet potato and parsnip. He's not like a big fan of those, but if I blend it with other things, he really likes it. If I put broccoli on anything, he will eat it and he will like eat the whole thing. So yes, broccoli, avocado, he didn't like avocado but he likes it now. Potato, butternut squash, sweet potato, parsnip, carrot, courgette, cauliflower. And with fruits, it's cooked apple, pear, mango, papaya or smashed banana. With like fruits, I always recommend doing them after you introduce vegetables. It's just easier to get them to like vegetables if you introduce vegetables first and then fruits later, which now he has fruits and he really likes them, but he likes savory foods and he likes all his vegetables apart from parsnip, which I said. But I just find that a really great tip that I got and I always give to mums that are weaning, because my daughter eats every single vegetable apart from onions and mushrooms. She doesn't like those, but everything else she eats it, and I definitely think it's because she did fruits a little bit later on. So that is it. I really hope that you found something useful about this video. I hope you have a lovely day, and until my next video, there's a mosquito in my house. I will see you guys soon. Bye.